Hello everyone, welcome back to Spoken English Session 4, and we are going to deal a very important topic of parts of speech, that is prepositions. Prepositions, the greatness of English language, we can split the word sometimes and try to understand the meaning of that word, many of the words. Okay, now we have already discussed noun, the tips related to noun, pronoun, verb, adverb and adjectives. We have also discussed how it is important to increase the command, you know, of language, like the number of adjectives we know, the command on English will improve. And that's why I told, please try to learn at least 2 or 3 adjectives per day, and that can happen through constant listening. Okay, now moving on, in order to, you know, write a sentence or speak a sentence in without any grammatical errors, right? Obviously the fundamental part of the language is grammar, and if you are able to make that grammar right, obviously whatever we speak and whatever we write, we sound them right. Okay, so in that aspect, in order to make a sentence grammatically correct, prepositions are very important. Yes, because without prepositions you cannot form a sentence correctly. Now let us try to keep it as simple as possible. The first caution, prepositions cannot be translated. That's why we told in the introduction video, I keep on saying, go back to the introduction video, we kept on saying that thinking in native language should be stopped, especially when we try to learn English. When we are listening English videos, we cannot keep thinking in our native language, whatever it might be, Telugu, Urdu or whatever it might be, and this translation from native language to English will spoil the whole process. That's where people fumble, that's where people do mistakes, etc. So prepositions cannot be translated, so try to keep it as original as possible, and try to keep your thought process in English. Thinking means self-talk, that's it. Now prepositions, as I told, this line defines words which connects nouns or pronouns with the other part of the sentence. Ramu is a noun. Ramu is in Hyderabad, right? So where is Ramu located? We are taking the preposition help, that is in. Okay, so it is connecting a noun or pronoun with the other part of the sentence. That is correct, right? So you need to stick to this basic line. Now there are a lot of prepositions, many prepositions. We can only pick the most used one in terms of competitive exams also, as well as in terms of speaking. So let us take some basic prepositions which keeps on occurring in our day-to-day life. First itself, on, right? On, yes. Now in what areas the prepositions are expanded to? You please focus on this. Direction, time, location, position. Either we are, you know, specifying the direction of the particular, you know, noun relation to the object, or time of something, location of something, or place. Location or place and position. Okay. Now, on is obviously, the pen is kept on the table. Yes, the pen is kept on the table. So you are defining the surface, right? This is one usage. Now, when are you coming? I am coming on Monday, right? I am coming on Monday. Now, very tricky one. This is summer and ice creams are on demand. Ice creams are on demand. So that is telling the position. Now prepositions, the trickiest part is it changes from context to context. Yes, context means the situation where it is placed to. So that's why we should be very careful with the prepositions. So now in case of in is again, it is percepted to, sorry, it is related to the location sometimes. It is related to the position sometimes, right? For example, I am in Hyderabad. Now this is location. I am in tension. I am in tension is actually giving you you are explaining the situation you are in, right? So this is the trickiest part of the preposition. So be careful. Prepositions are not meant only for one context. Now I'll give a very good example. Comparison of in and at, right? So somebody is asking you, where are you staying? Where are you staying right now, right? Some friend, some common friend met you and is asking, where are you staying these days? Now, I am staying in Hyderabad at Kompally. Means, for bigger location, you are giving in. For specific location, you are giving at. Right? So, that is how it is differentiated. And most of the times, we get to face these questions in competitive exams, etc., in sentence formation, etc. So, for bigger positions, for places, in. To be specific, at. Right? You can easily differentiate it. Right? Where are you waiting at? I'm waiting at the bus stop. You are being specific when you are using at. Same time for time also you use at 7 p.m. Right? So prepositions are very, very tricky sometimes, but until and unless you can understand the logic, it becomes so simple, usage after usage. Come back to position related prepositions. Yes, these are very easy to understand. Position related. Under, beneath. Now beneath is exactly position related, right? Beneath is under the surface. So where is my ball, or where is the, you know, a kid is asking, where is my ball? It is beneath the dining table. It is beneath the dining table, because under, not only for location, sometimes you use it for position also. I am working under my team leader, right? Yes, you are subjected under to this condition. Means under is not only for location, but beneath is exactly for location. It cannot be used for another context. Above, everybody knows. Behind, everybody knows. My house is situated behind this temple, this particular temple. Okay. Now, in front of is again a location related, position related preposition. Adjacent, you know, side by side. Adjacent to your home, there is a new shopping mall. Means something which is attached to. This is a very tricky one. Now, in spite of and despite, both stands the same meaning, but usage is different. In spite is always followed by of. In spite of fever, the player is playing good cricket, right? He is overcoming a situation, that's why you are using in spite of. When you are overcoming some situation, you are using in spite of. Same you can use, despite fever, he is playing good cricket. But despite does not have any of. Other than, you can use both. Since and for, very, very important. Since is for point of time. For is for period of time. This should be stick very, very strongly in your mind. Since is for point of time, right? Since 1947, you are exactly telling the point, right? Right? Since January, right? Then, for 16 days, I was waiting. 16 days is period of time, not point of time, right? I am waiting for you since morning, because morning is a point of time. I am waiting for you for 5 hours. 5 hours is a period of time. So that is the major difference. Okay? These, you know, in this way. Like for example, this is very tricky. Beside and a simple S. Besides. Besides again location related, right? Where are you living? Yeah? Beside to this particular place. Right? Besides is giving another option. I have an Alto besides to a Maruti, right? Means you are having both. To say you have two options or two both to another option or having both, you use besides. Okay, like these are rather than in daily life we are asked in this daily exams or subjective exams. Okay, so friends, there are a lot of prepositions. First method is try to understand in what context it can be used. Second, start using in regular life on daily language. Okay. Third one, increase the number of prepositions. First one is position related, location related, then time related, then so many other examples. See, for any language, the learning process remains the same, as discussed in the introduction video. There is so much we have discussed in the introduction video with the less time, so that for every topic, the fundamentals remains the same. English is just another language, and we can definitely master it through some right process. Thank you for watching, and please keep sharing.